How is he even a real estate agent? He can't even afford a suit.
First of all, I think I look really good in a t-shirt and a hoodie. But as a real estate agent, I get it. You're used to people in suits and ties. And big shout out to the guys that look really, really good in suits. I'm not one of them. I like to be comfortable. Hoodie, t-shirt for Jazzy.
So William 7173 says, "You're a real waste. Agents are all a scam. Next." Well, William 7173, I get the feeling that you probably had an awful experience with an agent. And the truth is, not all real estate agents are good at what they do. They're just in any industry in this world. And so I feel for you. I totally understand it. And my response just is, hey, look, I'm just trying to be the best real estate agent I can be. And I hope to lead with education.
Wow. Another real estate agent scamming people out of money.
I guess agents do stuff like that. That's not me. I've been doing this for 17 years. I'll give you a list of all my clients' names and numbers. You can ask them yourself.
So Fenton Mudd said, "You are full of baloney and a troll and very presumptuous." I then responded to this gentleman saying, like, a troll is a little bit harsh, don't you think? But I appreciate the feedback. He then comes back to me and says, "Sorry, love, troll was harsh. I just get upset when I see people pay their commissions on homes that they sell it on MLS rather than using an agent to sell it." So again, I gave him some feedback and he apologized, right? A lot of people are just really hot in the moment and they're just texting like crazy. And so it's okay to acknowledge the person, answer them with a little bit of love, and then they'll probably come back with the same thing.
This guy needs to stop doing videos. Check out his hairline, it's receding. Is it really? I think I got a fresh fade. Let me know.
Hi everyone and welcome to the FTGU Show. Today we are actually on location here in South Etobicoke. We're at the RevPrint Studio and we're doing a bunch of content today. We're doing photos, podcasts, live YouTube shows.
You saw Elle come into the shot. She obviously had to make a guest appearance.
That's our photographer. Awesome. We got Lisa here in the background who's running the studio, and my girl Toro who did my hair and makeup today. I actually put some effort in for
you guys. Why did you put in all the effort today, though?
Well, we're taking some photos.
Yes.
And I take some photos without all the effort, but every now and then it's like,
that's important to mention, right? Like the fact that, and we're going to talk about what this episode's going to be about today, but the fact that we shoot all of our content raw. You just naturally, obviously, are a lot easier on the eyes than I am in general.
Well, he says that now off camera. He just said, I've never heard the word gorgeous in my life.
When we're doing a shoot.
You're making fun of me.
When we're doing a shoot, because usually you have 22-year-old ass behind the camera. He's just like, let's get the heck out of here and get the shots done. But, at times, like, there's nothing wrong with, like, making sure you get to a studio and maybe twice a year, three times a year, maybe like a spring, summer shoot and a fall, winter shoot. I think it's really cool and it's been really nice to see our team involved. Obviously, Stephen Rochester, Yas, Parsa, but then to meet three new people now that, you know, we're obviously going to call on. And if you like some of the photos, you like some of like the space that we're in, just reach out to us. We'll put you in connection.
And we'll put everyone's contact info in the show
100%.
Notes.
They've been really, really cool. But today's episode is going to be about what?
I'm actually really excited for this one today because we hear this from our clients a lot. How do you guys deal with negative comments?
Yeah.
And I think it's first and foremost important to note that if you're just getting started on producing content, it's not like you're getting a million views on any one piece, unless you somehow go viral, but that's really, really rare, right?
Yeah.
So know that the majority of people who are seeing your content, they're your friends, they're your family, and they want you to win and succeed. And so you're probably not gonna get a lot of
negative did you say clients?
Critiques.
Like, did you actually
and your clients as well,
right?
Exactly.
Because that's what you're trying to be. You're not trying to be, we say it all the time, YouTube star, TikTok star, Instagram influencer. This is take your content, educational, and send it to your clients who they've done business with you. So chances of them telling you you don't look good and the stuff that we're going to go over, because you're going to read these.
They might give you some constructive criticism, but it's rare that they'll do that like in an actual comment.
Yeah, and don't be an ass and take that so like hard. Like if your clients are telling you that they don't like the fact that you talk about a specific property or maybe like you're selling too hard, like that stuff is constructive and
and you also have to know though, if only one person says it, that probably isn't a good enough sample size, right? So people come to us and say, oh, everyone told me the audio was bad. Everyone or like two people?
Well, it's like I don't know if we should go there because this is a media show, but at home, I'm sure we've all heard it from your partners. Like, yeah, never wash the dishes. You're like, what the heck?
You probably never wash the dishes.
Okay, so maybe that was a bad example. So you never clean up after yourself or whatever it is. Comments are like that. Like, agents and mortgage brokers come to us all the time and they're like, oh my God, everyone doesn't like my content. We're like, how many people told you that?
Yeah.
Two people? Like, that's not a big enough sample size. So then how do you deal with it, Laura?
So, well, with that, I mean, I just continue to put out more content.
Okay.
And you try to get better. Take their feedback. If you think it is constructive, then, like, maybe there are some changes you can make. But also know sometimes people are giving you feedback and it's like, look, I don't have the best audio equipment. I don't have the best camera right now. Don't let that stop you from doing it. It's more about getting the reps in, and the repetition will usually create better quality as you go along.
Yeah. Now, to Laura's point, when you start to produce more content, you are going to get negative feedback, or you're going to get people just trolling you or saying like really rude shit. And it generally comes from user65_58 and all that. And they're in their basement and they're keyboard warriors. To think anything else would be naive, right? But if the way that I deal with it anyways, and in my opinion, is if you have the mindset and understand that your intent is good, and you are putting out positive stuff. And look, to the real estate agents and the mortgage brokers, you're talking about educating people. You have your own opinions, and people are gonna have their own opinions, and you don't need to always, it doesn't always have to be combative, right? Once you understand that your intent is good, you just need to keep going. It gets a lot easier to deal with.
I think a lot of people are probably watching this who know you, Jazz, are like, oh, that's easy for Jazz to say. He walks around with all the confidence in the world. And so it's, you know, no skin off his back. Hair? Skin? Hair
either,
off your back?
Either
what's
way,
the saying?
You suck when it comes to these kind of sayings anyway.
Skin
so
off my back?
Yeah, no, it's
hair
skin
off.
Skin off my back.
Oh,
yeah,
I had it right the first time. But
see, look, we didn't stop this podcast. Like, on other, like, stuff that we've done before, we tell you, you keep going, you roll with the punches.
Exactly. But I think, you know, from my vantage point, when I do get some negative critiques, sometimes they do hurt. Like, sometimes I read them, I'm like, oh my gosh, like, that's mean. That's pretty harsh. And we're actually going to take some of the comments you're going to see just after this, some of the comments that we actually get and our real reactions to those and what we may have written back or what we feel inside versus what we write back. And I think the important part to note is whatever they're saying, if they're sitting at their house taking the time out of their day to write you a comment that's not nice, not supportive to an absolute stranger, chances are something's going on in their life.
Oh yeah, I love that.
And they're maybe hurting in their own way.
Yep.
They're not happy with what's going on with them in their lives. And so I try not to take it too personally. You have to take a look at who's the person saying it to me. Do I even know this person? Does this person know anything about me? And I find, like, especially on the TikToks of the world, like it's almost humorous. Like you almost have to come at it with like a sense of humor because it's, it can get pretty harsh.
100% it can.
But it's,
because
that's
the platform that has the user 65, because the way that it's set up is that you don't need to put your first and last name even on it, right?
And here's the thing. I also then go and I look at their profile, the person who's saying it, and chances are the person who's saying something mean, they've never posted a single piece of content.
Yeah.
They don't even have a picture.
A profile pic, yeah.
So it's like this person is so self-conscious, they can't even be themselves online. And here we are trying to put ourselves out there.
Yeah.
And so, you know, I always try and give myself a pat on the back and say, I think I'm winning in the long run.
And look, again, going back to what you said, that someone who leaves like negative comments, they probably do that on a lot of people's profiles. There is something happening in their life. And so if you have a slight paradigm shift and you're able to say to yourself, you know what, how can I possibly help this person? Like, I reply back to people all the time and say, I'm sorry you feel like that, but like, here's my phone number. Give me a call. Like, maybe you just need someone to talk to. And I'm not saying that in a sarcastic way. It's like, I really want to try to help.
I don't want to talk to that.
Well, yeah, I get
User 65.
Yeah, but like, they never call.
Of course.
they never
respond to the comment.
100%.
Usually, yeah.
They never do any of that. But Parcel just walked in the room with a bunch of burgers. So I know
so
you're
I got to go eat.
You got to go eat. You guys watch how we actually reply back to people's comments and our thoughts, as Laura mentioned.
Yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this one.